So Frank, you're about to be married. How does it feel?
Feels like a dream come true. Feels amazing. We've been engaged for a year, and I'm just so happy it's here, and I'm so ready to have this day with family and friends here at the church and at the ceremony afterwards.
So Rosaline, you're about to be married. How does it feel?
It's really exciting. I'm excited. I don't know. I mean, I'm ready, I guess.
Thank you. We made it. Awesome, awesome, awesome. I have been waiting for this celebration for so long. Usually the wedding rehearsal's right before, but throughout the New Year's celebration, just waiting for this new beginning. It's not just a new year, it's a new lifetime that we begin. As you come before the Lord to take your relationship and bring it before Him, that He may supercharge it in the sacred covenant, the sacrament of marriage. All of you, welcome. It's great to have you here, and especially for those of you who traveled so far. Your presence here is a great sign of your love for Frank and Rose. And not only that, but the way you stand for and believe in what they're about to embark on in the covenant of marriage. You, each of you, have been invited here by name because you're the ones who really made this day happen. You're the ones who supported them throughout life's journey. You taught them what love was all about, giving them, if you will, the pat on the back when they needed it and the swift kick when they might have needed it even more. And so they wanted you here, not only for your presence, but especially for your prayers, that the love that they share may continue to grow and to blossom with each breath that they take, with each beat of their heart. If you're willing to accept their invitation, I invite you to join me as we invoke our God by name, that He may bless their love, and that their love may continue to abound with each passing day, with each passing moment. Let's pray. Holy Father, when you created mankind, you willed that man and woman should become one in the holy covenant of marriage. We ask that you bind Frank and Rosalie in the loving union of marriage and make their love fruitful so that they may be living witnesses to your divine love in the world. We ask you this through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever. Amen. Amen. Please be seated for the Word of God.
Wax. She didn't want gel, she wanted wax. I know. is not pompous. It is not inflated. It is not rude. It does not seek its own interest. It is not quick-tempered, and it does not rule over you. It does not rejoice over wrongdoing, but rejoices with the truth. It bears all things, believes all things, and hopes all things, and endures all things. Love never fails. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John. Glory to you, O Lord. Jesus looked up to heaven and said, Father, I do not pray for them alone. I pray also for those who believe in me through their word, that all may be one, as you, Father, are in me, and I in you. I pray that they will be one in us, that the world may believe that you sent me. I have given them the glory that you gave me, that they may be one, as we are one. I live in them, you living in me, that their unity may be complete. So shall the world know that you sent me, and that you love them as you loved me. Father, all those you gave me, I would have in my company where I am, to see this glory of mine, which is your gift to me, because of the love you bore me before the world began. Just Father, the world has not known you, but I have known you, and these men have known that you sent me. To them I have revealed your name, and I will continue to reveal it, so that your love for me may live in them, and I may live in them. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Please be seated. First of all, again, on behalf of Frank and Rosalie, I'd like to thank you all for being here, and especially those who travel from afar, or those who are of the Catholic faith. I hope that you feel right at home here at St. Paul's. Really, it's my delight to have you here. And it's a real great privilege to be able to celebrate this wedding. If I had a regret, it was that they do all their wedding preparation with another priest. That was the only regret, because you guys are just amazing. Really, really phenomenal.
Thank you, Father.
The readings that they chose for us are great readings, unusual readings in many ways. Now, we've heard 1 Corinthians of many weddings, but the other two, you might not have heard that much about. The first reading from the book of Tobit is an amazing reading. I remember when I was a grad student at Florida State University, I had a Bible study in my dorm room, and when we covered that chapter, I wrote in my margins, I said, that when I get married, that's the reading I want to have. You know, it's just a great reading. The story of Tobit, and the book itself, actually, is one of those books that you find in the Catholic Bible, not in the Protestant Bible. So if you haven't heard it before, that's why. You may find it in the back of your Bible, in the Protestant Bible, in the, what they call the Deuteronomical or Apocryphal section. It's a set of books that were in the Jewish, in the Greek translation of the Bible that Jesus used, the apostles used, that the Catholic Church has always kept. Later on, in around the year 100, during the Council of Vienna, those books were removed from the Jewish Bible. So they, when the Protestant Reformation came, they followed that canon of scripture. But the point of it is very, very good. point of it is that this couple realized, Tobias and Sarah, that the only way their love would survive the night was through God's grace. She was being plagued by a demon, and the demon was killing off anyone that she loved. Then through the intercession of God, the Archangel Raphael, and the prayer that they offered to God, they asked God to protect her from the evil of the world. And I think it's a beautiful prayer, and so applicable today, because what studies are showing us is that when it comes out to success in a relationship, what is the key ingredient really is God. You know, and you know that, and I think that's so huge. You know, the fact that you met, and so quickly, within a month, realized that she was the one, that he is the one. And then how your relationship grew, not only in an interpersonal relationship, but in a God way, is really phenomenal. Let me explain a little bit about what I'm talking about. From a Christian perspective, what we believe is that, from John's Gospel, is that God is love. And so when you talk about what the two of you share, it's really love. Love is the thing that brings you together. What you love in Frank is the God shining through him. It's all that's good, that's holy, that's strong, that's noble, that's caring, that's sensitive. All that you love in Rosalind is God shining through her. The love that she has for you, her gentleness, her sense of humor, the way she gives of herself. That's the God. What you love in each other is God. So in a sense, if you take your relationship, and God's here and you're two here, the more that you grow in God, the more that you grow in each other. And what's neat about your engagement is that you did just that, is that you really grew together in God. And what you share is God. They say couples that pray together stay together, and that's certainly true. They take a look at the divorce rate, it's about 40% at this point in time. When you take a look at couples that are married together, Catholic couples married together, that don't live together prior to marriage, the divorce rate is less than 3%. It's very, very small. Why? Because if you practice your faith, if you have God as an integral part of your life, then when he does, he's the light at the end of the tunnel. He gives us the strength that we need to deal with the difficult times and the challenges. He's the one who gives us the moral principles to help guide our marriage, to keep it adultery-proof, if you will. He's the one that helps us to realize what our values are. That it's not about money. It's not about popularity. It's not about prestige. It's about faith. It's about hope. It's about love. It's about family. And you get that. And I think that is just so, so very, very cool. And your gospel that you chose for us exemplifies that even more. That God may remain in you, that Jesus may remain in you, and that your love may increase each and every day. I think that is so phenomenal and so absolutely beautiful. When you think about it, how God is already working in your life, it's very, very exciting. And I can't wait to see where you're going to be 5 years from now, or 10 years from now, or 15 years from now, or 20 years from now. Or today, earlier today, I celebrated a funeral for a man. He's married to his wife for 68 years, you know? I can't imagine, you know, a lifetime of love. And that's my prayer for you, is that you'll be able to journey hand in hand in faith, as a family, as a team, to be able to journey through all that life has to offer, with all the exciting and wonderful things and the challenging things, that your love will become purified and more purified, so that when people see you, you may truly be a sacrament. Let me explain a little bit what we're talking about. We talk about the marriage ceremony today. There's actually three things that are happening all at once. The first is the civil ceremony. They already signed a certificate at their kind of clerk's office. They probably told you that for $20 you can save a lot of money and get married right there or something, right? Mm-hmm. Yeah. But afterwards, I married him today. I married him. And you guys signed a certificate and you're done. You know, it's very, very easy. We don't really talk much about that, too much about it. The second one is the natural marriage. For us, it's very different than the state. The state believes that marriage is simply a stable relationship between two people. We believe that marriage is a covenant. It's a sacred relationship. And that you give each other in marriage. That what makes it a marriage is that one profession of love. It's praying, pouring himself out into Rosalie with all his strengths and all his weaknesses. And she accepting him fully for who he is. And then she giving herself totally to him in her vows, with all of her strengths and with all of her weaknesses. That public exchange of persons is what we believe marriage to be. You give each other in marriage. That out of marrying, you marry each other, which is beautiful. But we also believe, because we're both baptized, that not them, not me, but Christ himself raises their marriage to the dignity of being a sacrament, a visible sign of God's grace. When you think about it, when you see a married couple, you see the love they share, you see a family, you see the face of God. God is a family person. And when the Bible talks about God's love for us, more often than not, it describes it as a nuptial love, as a love between husband and wife. It's a divine choice, an election that God makes for us. That when people see you, when they see the love that you have shared, and as that love continues to grow and deepen and mature, they'll be able to see in you the face of God. And when they see you with all your little Rosalines and all your little friends running around, that will be even more evident to them. Our prayer for you, as I prayed for both of you before we began, is that today won't be the happiest day of your life. Our prayer for you is that tomorrow will be even happier, and the day after that will be even happier after. And 10 years from now, 20 years from now, 50 years from now, who knows, 75 years from now, that when you'll be able to journey hand in hand in that lifetime of love. If this is your prayer, if that's your hope, I ask you to stand before the altar of God and confess that love for both God and his people. As they prepare to exchange vows, but I ask those of you who are married to take a hold of the one that you love. Renew your vows. You know that it's not enough to say, I do, and then you're done. And it's a day-to-day choice, a day-to-day decision. For those who are separated from those you love, remember that nothing ever separates us from our those we love, not in death. And for the rest of you, who are sort of desperate neighbors like me, let's pray for that. My dear friends, Frank and Rosalie, you've come together in this beautiful church so that the Lord may seal and strengthen your love in the presence of the church's minister and the presence of this wonderful community of faith. Christ has already abundantly blessed your love. He has consecrated you in the sacrament of baptism. I ask you now to renew that baptismal vows. My friends, do you believe in God, the Father, the Almighty, creator of heaven and earth?
We do.
Do you believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried, on the third day rose again, and is now seated at the right hand of God, our living Father?
We do.
Do you believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting?
We do.
Friends, this is our faith. This is the faith of we who are the church. We're proud to confess it through Christ Jesus our Lord. Amen. My friends, the Lord now desires to enrich you and strengthen you by a special sacrament, so that you may assume the duties of marriage in mutual and lasting fidelity. And so in the presence of God's people, I ask you to state your intentions. Frank, Rosalie, have you come here freely and without reservation to give yourselves to each other in marriage?
We have.
We love and honor each other as husband and wife for the rest of your lives.
We will.
Will you accept children lovingly from God and bring them up according to the law of Christ and his church?
We will.
Since it's your intention to enter into marriage, I ask you to declare your consent before God and his people.
I, Frank.
Take you, Rosaline. To be my lawful wife. To have and to hold.
From this day forward.
For better or for worse.
For richer or for poorer.
In sickness and in health.
Until death do us part.
I, Rosaline.
Take you, Frank. For my lawful husband. To have and to hold. From this day forward. For better or for worse.
For richer or for poorer.
In sickness and in health.
Until death do us part.
Until death do us part.
My friends, you have declared your consent before the church. May the Lord in his goodness strengthen your consent and fill you both with his blessings. What God has done, no one may have done.
That makes sense.
Lord our God, we ask that you bless and consecrate Frank and Rosaline in their love for each other. May these rings serve as a symbol of the true faith they have in you and in one another, and always remind them of the love which binds them together. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen.
Rosaline, take this ring
as a sign of my love and fidelity.
As a sign of my love and fidelity.
In the name of the Father,
and of the Son,
and of the Holy Spirit.
Frank, take this ring
as a sign of my love and fidelity.
As a sign of my love and fidelity.
In the name of the Father,
in the name of the Father,
and of the Son,
and of the Son,
and of the Holy Spirit.
And of the Holy Spirit.
And you make a shout. Praise God.
So Frank, you're about to be married. How does it feel?
Feels like a dream come true. Feels amazing. We've been engaged for a year, and I'm just so happy it's here, and I'm so ready to have this day with family and friends here at the church and at the ceremony afterwards.
So Rosaline, you're about to be married. How does it feel?
It's really exciting. I'm excited. I don't know. I mean, I'm ready, I guess.
Thank you.
We made it. Awesome, awesome, awesome. I have been waiting for this celebration for so long. Usually the wedding rehearsal's right before, but throughout the New Year's celebration, just waiting for this new beginning. It's not just a new year, it's a new lifetime that we begin. As you come before the Lord to take your relationship and bring it before Him, that He may supercharge it in the sacred covenant, the sacrament of marriage. All of you, welcome. It's great to have you here, and especially for those of you who traveled so far. Your presence here is a great sign of your love for Frank and Rose. And not only that, but the way you stand for and believe in what they're about to embark on in the covenant of marriage. You, each of you, have been invited here by name because you're the ones who really made this day happen. You're the ones who supported them throughout life's journey. You taught them what love was all about, giving them, if you will, the pat on the back when they needed it and the swift kick when they might have needed it even more. And so they wanted you here, not only for your presence, but especially for your prayers, that the love that they share may continue to grow and to blossom with each breath that they take, with each beat of their heart. If you're willing to accept their invitation, I invite you to join me as we invoke our God by name, that He may bless their love, and that their love may continue to abound with each passing day, with each passing moment. Let's pray. Holy Father, when you created mankind, you willed that man and woman should become one in the holy covenant of marriage. We ask that you bind Frank and Rosalie in the loving union of marriage and make their love fruitful so that they may be living witnesses to your divine love in the world. We ask you this through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever. Amen. Amen. Please be seated for the Word of God.
Gel wax. She didn't want gel, she wanted wax. I know.
not inflated, it is not rude, it does not seek its own interest, it is not quick-tempered, and it does not rule over the truth. It does not rejoice over wrongdoing, but rejoices with the truth. It bears all things, believes all things, and hopes all things, and endures all things. Love never fails. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John. Glory to you, O Lord. Jesus looked up to heaven and said, Father, I do not pray for them alone. I pray also for those who believe in me through their word, that all may be one, as you, Father, are in me, and I in you. I pray that they will be one in us, that the world may believe that you sent me. I have given them the glory that you gave me, that they may be one, as we are one. I live in them, you living in me, that their unity may be complete. So shall the world know that you sent me, and that you love them as you loved me. Father, all those you gave me, I will have in my company where I am. Receive this glory of mine, which is your gift to me, because of the love you bore me before the world began. Just Father, the world has not known you, but I have known you, and these men have known that you sent me. To them I have revealed your name, and I will continue to reveal it, so that your love for me may live in them, and I may live in them. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Please be seated. First of all, again, on behalf of Frank and Rosalie, I'd like to thank you all for being here, and especially those who traveled from afar, or those who are of the Catholic faith. I hope that you feel right at home here at St. Paul's. Really, it's my delight to have you here. And it's a real great privilege to be able to celebrate this wedding. If I had regret, it was that they do all their wedding preparation with another priest. That was the only regret, because you guys are just amazing. Really, really phenomenal.
Thank you, Father.
The readings that they chose for us are great readings, unusual readings in many ways. Now, we've heard 1 Corinthians of many weddings, but the other two you might not have heard that much about. The first reading from the book of Tobit is an amazing reading. I remember when I was a grad student at Florida State University, I had a Bible study in my dorm room, and when we covered that chapter, I wrote in my margins, I said, that when I get married, that's the reading I want to have. You know, it's just a great reading. The story of Tobit, and the book itself actually, is one of those books that you find in the Catholic Bible, not in the Protestant Bible, so if you haven't heard it before, that's why. You may find in the back of your Bible, if you have a Protestant Bible, in what they call the Deuteronomical or Apocryphal section. It's a set of books that were in the Jewish, in the Greek translation of the Bible that Jesus used, and the apostles used, that the Catholic Church has always kept. Later on, in around the year 100, during the Council of Vienna, those books were removed from the Jewish Bible. So they, when the Protestant Reformation came, they followed that canon of Scripture. But the point of it is very, very good. The point of it is that this couple realized, Tobias and Sarah, that the only way their love would survive the night was through God's grace. She was being plagued by a demon, and the demon was killing off anyone that she loved. Then, through the intercession of God, the Archangel Raphael, and the prayer that they offered to God, they asked God to protect her from the evil of the world. And I think it's a beautiful prayer, and so applicable today, because what studies are showing us is that when it comes out to success in a relationship, what is the key ingredient really is God. You know, and you know that. I think that's so huge. You know, the fact that you met and so quickly, within a month, realized that she was the one, that he is the one. And then how your relationship grew, not only in an interpersonal relationship, but in a God way, is really phenomenal. Let me explain a little bit about what I'm talking about. From a Christian perspective, what we believe is that from John's gospel is that God is love. And so when you talk about what the two of you share, it's really love. Love is the thing that brings you together. What you love in Frank is the God shining through him. It's all that's good, that's holy, that's strong, that's noble, that's caring, that's sensitive. All that you love in Rosalind is God shining through her. The love that she has for you, her gentleness, her sense of humor, the way she gives of herself. That's the God. What you love in each other is God. So in a sense, if you take your relationship, and God's here and you're two here, the more that you grow in God, the more that you grow in each other. And what's neat about your engagement is that you did just that, is that you really grew together in God. And what you share is God. They say couples that pray together stay together, and that's certainly true. But take a look at the divorce rate, it's about 40% at this point in time. When you take a look at couples that are married together, Catholic couples married together, that don't live together prior to marriage, the divorce rate is less than 3%. It's very, very small. Why? Because if you practice your faith, if you have God as an intricate part of your life, then when he does, he's the light at the end of the tunnel. He gives us the strength that we need to deal with the difficult times and the challenges. He's the one who gives us the moral principles to help guide our marriage, to keep it adultery-proof, if you will. He's the one that helps us to realize what our values are. It's not about money. It's not about popularity. It's not about prestige. It's about faith. It's about hope. It's about love. It's about family. And you get that. And I think that is just so, so very, very cool. And your gospel that you chose for us exemplifies that even more. That God may remain in you, that Jesus may remain in you, and that your love may increase each and every day. I think that is so phenomenal and so absolutely beautiful. When you think about it, how God is already working in your life, it's very, very exciting. And I can't wait to see where you're going to be 5 years from now, or 10 years from now, or 15 years from now, or 20 years from now. Or today, earlier today, I celebrated a funeral for a man. He's married to his wife for 68 years, you know? I can't imagine, you know, a lifetime of love. And that's my prayer for you, is that you'll be able to journey hand in hand in faith, as a family, as a team, to be able to journey through all that life has to offer, with all the exciting and wonderful things and the challenging things, that your love will become purified and more purified, so that when people see you, you may truly be a sacrament. Let me explain a little bit what we're talking about. We talk about the marriage ceremony today. There's actually three things that happen all at once. The first is the civil ceremony. They already signed a certificate at their kind of clerk's office. They probably told you that for $20 you can save a lot of money and get married right there or something, right? Mm-hmm. Yeah. But afterwards, I married him today, I married her, and you guys signed a certificate and we're done. You know, it's very, very easy. We don't really talk much about that, too much about it. The second one is the natural marriage. For us, it's very different than the state. The state believes that marriage is simply a stable relationship between two people. We believe that marriage is a covenant. It's a sacred relationship. And then you give each other in marriage. That what makes it a marriage is that one profession of love. It's Frank pouring himself out into Rosalie with all his strengths and all his weaknesses. And she's letting him flow with who he is. And then she giving herself totally to him in her vows, with all of her strengths and with all of her weaknesses. That public exchange of persons is what we believe marriage to be. You give each other in marriage. That out of marrying, you marry each other, which is beautiful. But we also believe, because we're both baptized, that not them, not me, but Christ himself, raises their marriage to the dignity of being a sacrament, a visible sign of God's grace. When you think about it, when you see a married couple, you see the love they share, when you see a family, you see the face of God. It's a divine choice of election that God makes for us. That when people see you, when they see the love that you have shared, and as that love continues to grow and deepen and mature, they'll be able to see in you the face of God. And when they see you with all your little Rosalines and all your little friends running around, that will be even more evident to them. Our prayer for you, as I prayed for both of you before we began, is that today won't be the happiest day of your life. Our prayer for you is that tomorrow will be even happier, and the day after that will be even happier after. And 10 years from now, 20 years from now, 50 years from now, who knows, 75 years from now, that when you'll be able to journey hand in hand in that lifetime of love. If this is your prayer, if that's your hope, I ask you to stand before the altar of God and confess that love for both God and his people. As the invitation shakes out, but I ask those of you who are married to take a hold of the one that you love. We do your vows. We know that it's not about to say, I do, and you're done. And it's a day-to-day choice, a day-to-day decision. For those of you who are separated from those you love, remember that nothing ever separates us from our those we love, that and that. And for the rest of you who are sort of desperate to make us like me, let's pray for that. My dear friends, Frank and Rosalie, you've come together in this beautiful church so that the Lord may seal and strengthen your love in the presence of the church's minister and the presence of this wonderful community of faith. Christ has already abundantly blessed your love. He has consecrated you in the sacrament of baptism. I ask you now to renew that baptismal vows. My friends, do you believe in God, the Father, the Almighty, creator of heaven and earth?
We do.
Do you believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried, on the third day rose again, and is now seated at the right hand of God, our living Father?
We do.
Do you believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting?
We do.
Friends, this is our faith. This is the faith of we who are the church. We're proud to confess it through Christ Jesus our Lord. Amen. My friends, the Lord now desires to enrich you and strengthen you by a special sacrament, so that you may assume the duties of marriage in mutual and lasting fidelity. And so, in the presence of God's people, I ask you to state your intentions. Frank, Rosalie, have you come here freely and without reservation to give yourselves to each other in marriage?
We have.
We love and honor each other as husband and wife for the rest of your lives.
We will.
Will you accept children lovingly from God and bring them up according to the law of Christ and his church?
We will.
Since it's your intention to enter into marriage, I ask you to declare your consent before God and his people.
I, Frank,
take you, Rosaline,
to be my lawful wife,
to have and to hold,
from this day forward,
for better or for worse,
for richer or for poorer,
in sickness and in health,
until death do us part.
I, Rosaline,
take you, Frank,
for my lawful husband,
to have and to hold,
from this day forward,
for better or for worse,
for richer or for poor,
in sickness and in health, until death do us part.
My friends, you have declared your consent before the church.
May the Lord in his goodness strengthen your consent and fill you both with his blessings. What God has done, no one may have divided.
That makes sense.
Lord our God, we ask that you bless and consecrate Frank and Rosaline in their love for each other. May these rings serve as a symbol of the true faith they have in you and in one another, and always remind them of the love which binds them together. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen.
Rosaline, take this ring
as a sign of my love and fidelity.
As a sign of my love and fidelity.
In the name of the Father,
and of the Son,
and of the Holy Spirit.
Frank, take this ring
as a sign of my love and fidelity.
As a sign of my love and fidelity.
In the name of the Father,
and of the Son,
and of the Son,
and of the Holy Spirit. And of the Holy Spirit.
And you make a Shabbat.
Praise God.
So Frank, you're about to be married. How does it feel?
Feels like a dream come true. Feels amazing. We've been engaged for a year, and I'm just so happy it's here, and I'm so ready to have this day with family and friends here at the church and at the ceremony afterwards.
So Rosaline, you're about to be married. How does it feel?
It's really exciting. I'm excited. I don't know. I mean, I'm ready, I guess.
Thank you.
We made it. Awesome, awesome, awesome. I have been waiting for this celebration for so long. Usually the wedding rehearsal's right before, but throughout the New Year's celebration, just waiting for this new beginning. It's not just a new year, it's a new lifetime that we begin. As you come before the Lord to take your relationship and bring it before Him, that He may supercharge it in the sacred covenant, the sacrament of marriage. All of you, welcome. It's great to have you here, and especially for those of you who traveled so far. Your presence here is a great sign of your love for Frank and Rose. And not only that, but the way you stand for and believe in what they're about to embark on in the covenant of marriage. You, each of you, have been invited here by name because you're the ones who really made this day happen. You're the ones who supported them throughout life's journey. You taught them what love was all about, giving them, if you will, the pat on the back when they needed it and the swift kick when they might have needed it even more. And so they wanted you here, not only for your presence, but especially for your prayers, that the love that they share may continue to grow and to blossom with each breath that they take, with each beat of their heart. If you're willing to accept their invitation, I invite you to join me as we invoke our God by name, that He may bless their love, and that their love may continue to abound with each passing day, with each passing moment. Let's pray. Holy Father, when you created mankind, you willed that man and woman should become one in the holy covenant of marriage. We ask that you bind Frank and Rosalie in the loving union of marriage and make their love fruitful so that they may be living witnesses to your divine love in the world. We ask you this through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever. Amen. Amen. Please be seated for the Word of God.
Gel wax. She didn't want gel, she wanted wax. I know.
with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John. Glory to you, O Lord. Jesus looked up to heaven and said, Father, I do not pray for them alone. I pray also for those who believe in me through their word, that all may be one, as you, Father, are in me, and I in you. I pray that they will be one in us, that the world may believe that you sent me. I have given them the glory that you gave me, that they may be one, as we are one. I live in them, you living in me, that their unity may be complete. So shall the world know that you sent me, and that you love them as you loved me. Father, all those you gave me, I would have in my company where I am, to see this glory of mine, which is your gift to me, because of the love you bore me before the world began. Just Father, the world has not known you, but I have known you. And these men have known that you sent me. To them I have revealed your name, and I will continue to reveal it, so that your love for me may live in them, and I may live in them. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Please be seated. First of all, again, on behalf of Frank and Rosalie, I'd like to thank you all for being here, and especially those who traveled from afar, or those who are of the Catholic faith. I hope that you feel right at home here at St. Paul's. Really, it's my delight to have you here, and it's a real great privilege to be able to celebrate this wedding. If I had a regret, it was that they do all their wedding preparation with another priest. That was the only regret, because you guys are just amazing, really, really phenomenal.
Thank you, Father.
The readings that they chose to us are great readings, unusual readings in many ways. Now, we've heard 1 Corinthians of many weddings, but the other two you might not have heard that much about. The first reading from the book of Tobit is an amazing reading. I remember when I was a grad student at Florida State University, I had a Bible study in my dorm room, and when we covered that chapter, I wrote in my margins, I said, that when I get married, that's the reading I want to have. You know, it's just a great reading. The story of Tobit, and the book itself actually is one of those books that you find in the Catholic Bible, not in the Protestant Bible. So if you haven't heard it before, that's why. You may find it in the back of your Bible, if you have a Protestant Bible, in what they call the Deuteronomical or Apocryphal section. It's a set of books that were in the Jewish, in the Greek translation of the Bible that Jesus used, the apostles used, that the Catholic Church has always kept. Later on, in around the year 100, during the Council of Giannia, those books were removed from the Jewish Bible. So they, when the Protestant Reformation came, they followed that canon of Scripture. But the point of it is very, very good. The point of it is that this couple realized, Tobias and Sarah, that the only way their love would survive the night was through God's grace. She was being plagued by a demon, and the demon was killing off anybody that she loved. That through the intercession of God, the Archangel Raphael, and the prayer that they offer to God, they ask God to protect them from the evil of the world. And I think it's a beautiful prayer, and so applicable today, because what studies are showing us is that when it comes out to success in a relationship, what is the key ingredient really is God. You know, and you know that, and I think that's so huge. You know, the fact that you met, and so quickly, within a month, realized that she was the one, that he is the one. And then how your relationship grew, not only in an interpersonal relationship, but in a God way, is really phenomenal. Let me explain a little bit about what I'm talking about. From a Christian perspective, what we believe is that, from John's Gospel, is that God is love. And so when you talk about what the two of you share, it's really love. Love is the thing that brings you together. What you love in Frank is the God shining through him. It's all that's good, that's holy, that's strong, that's noble, that's caring, that's sensitive. All that you love in Rosalind is God shining through her. The love that she has for you, her gentleness, her sense of humor, the way she gives of herself. That's the God. What you love in each other is God. So in a sense, if you take your relationship And if God's here and the two here, the more that you grow in God, the more that you grow in each other. And what's neat about your engagement is that you did just that, is that you really grew together in God. And what you share is God. They say couples that pray together stay together. That's certainly true. When you take a look at the divorce rate, it's about 40% at this point in time. When you take a look at couples that are married together, Catholic couples married together, that don't live together prior to marriage, the divorce rate is less than 3%. It's very, very small. Why? Because if you practice your faith, if you have God as an integral part of your life, then when he does, he's the light at the end of the tunnel. He gives us the strength that we need to deal with the difficult times and the challenges. He's the one who gives us the moral principles to help guide our marriage, to keep it adultery-proof, if you will. He's the one that helps us to realize what our values are. That it's not about money. It's not about popularity. It's not about prestige. It's about faith. It's about hope. It's about love. It's about family. And you get that. And I think that is just so, so very, very cool. And your gospel that you chose for us exemplifies that even more. That God may remain in you, that Jesus may remain in you, and that your love may increase each and every day. I think that is so phenomenal and so absolutely beautiful. When you think about it, how God is already working in your life, it's very, very exciting, and I can't wait to see where you're going to be 5 years from now, or 10 years from now, or 15 years from now, or 20 years from now. Or today, earlier today, I celebrated a funeral for a man. He's married to his wife for 68 years, you know? I can't imagine, you know, a lifetime of love. And that's my prayer for you, is that you'll be able to journey hand in hand in faith, as a family, as a team, to be able to journey through all that life has to offer, with all the exciting and wonderful things and the challenging things, that your love will become purified and more purified. So that when people see you, you may truly be a sacrament. Let me explain a little bit what we're talking about. We talk about the marriage ceremony today. There's actually three things that happen all at once. The first is the civil ceremony. They already signed a certificate at their kind of clerk's office. They probably told you that for $20 you can save a lot of money and get married right there or something, right? Mm-hmm. Yeah. But afterwards, I married him today, I married him, and you guys signed a certificate and you're done. You know, it's very, very easy. We don't really talk much about that, too much about it. The second one is the natural marriage. For us, it's very different than the state. The state believes that marriage is simply a stable relationship between two people. We believe that marriage is a covenant. It's a sacred relationship. And that you give each other in marriage. That what makes it a marriage is that one professional love. It's pouring himself out into Rosalie with all his strengths and all his weaknesses. And she accepting him fully for who he is. And then she giving herself totally to him in her vows, with all of her strengths and with all of her weaknesses. That public exchange of persons is what we believe marriage to be. You give each other in marriage. That out of marrying, you marry each other, which is beautiful. But we also believe, because we're both baptized, that not them, not me, but Christ himself, raises their marriage to the dignity of being a sacrament, a visible sign of God's grace. When you think about it, when you see a married couple, you see the love they share, when you see a family, you see the face of God. God is a family person. And when the Bible talks about God's love for us, more often than not, it describes it as a nuptial love, as a love between a husband and wife. It's a divine choice, an election that God makes for us. That when people see you, when they see the love that you have shared, and as that love continues to grow and deepen and mature, they'll be able to see in you the face of God. And when they see you with all your little Rosalines and all your little friends running around, that will be even more evident to them. Our prayer for you, as I prayed for both of you before we began, is that today won't be the happiest day of your life. Our prayer for you is that tomorrow will be even happier. And the day after that will be even happier. And 10 years from now, 20 years from now, 50 years from now, who knows, 75 years from now, that when you'll be able to journey hand in hand in that lifetime of love. If this is your prayer, if that's your hope, I ask you to stand before the altar of God and confess that love to both God and his people. As they prepare to exchange vows, but I ask those of you who are married to take a hold of the one that you love, renew your vows, you know that it's not about the and it's a day-to-day choice, a day-to-day decision. For those who are separated from those who love, remember that nothing ever separates us from our those who love, not in death. And for the rest of you, who are sort of desperate neighbors like me, let's pray for that. My dear friends, Frank and Rosalie, you've come together in this beautiful church so that the Lord may seal and strengthen your love in the presence of the church's minister and the presence of this wonderful community of faith. Christ has already abundantly blessed your love. He has consecrated you in the sacrament of baptism. I ask you now to renew that baptismal vows. My friends, do you believe in God, the Father, the Almighty, creator of heaven and earth?
We do.
Do you believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried, on the third day rose again, and is now seated at the right hand of God, our living Father?
We do.
Do you believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting?
We do.
Friends, this is our faith. This is the faith of we who are the church, who are proud to confess it through Christ Jesus our Lord. Amen. My friends, the Lord now desires to enrich you and strengthen you by a special sacrament, so that you may assume the duties of marriage in mutual and lasting fidelity. And so, in the presence of God's people, I ask you to state your intentions. Frank, Rosalie, have you come here freely and without reservation to give yourselves to each other in marriage?
We have.
We love and honor each other as husband and wife for the rest of your lives.
We will.
Will you accept children lovingly from God and bring them up according to the law of Christ and his church?
We will.
Since it's your intention to enter the marriage, I ask you to declare your consent before God and his people.
I, Frank.
Take you, Rosaline. To be my lawful wife. To have and to hold.
From this day forward.
For better or for worse.
For richer or for poorer.
In sickness and in health.
Until death do us part.
I, Rosaline.
Take you, Frank. For my lawful husband.
To have and to hold.
From this day forward.
For better or for worse.
For richer or for poor.
In sickness and in health.
Until death do us part.
My friends, you have declared your consent before the church. May the Lord in his goodness strengthen your consent and fill you both with his blessings. What God has done, no one may ever divide.
That makes sense.
Lord our God, we ask that you bless and consecrate Frank and Rosaline in their love for each other. May these rings serve as a symbol of the true faith they have in you and in one another, and always remind them of the love which binds them together. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen.
Rosaline, take this ring.
As a sign of my love and fidelity.
In the name of the Father.
And of the Son.
And of the Holy Spirit.
And of the Holy Spirit.
Frank, take this ring.
As a sign of my love and fidelity.
As a sign of my love and fidelity.
In the name of the Father.
In the name of the Father.
And of the Son.
And of the Son.
And of the Holy Spirit.
And of the Holy Spirit.
Praise God.